Hello everyone, this is Ivan and today's video is going to be about what I bring with me in my travel toiletries bag. The inspiration for this video came to me courtesy of Jerome from Oh It's Rome. That's the name of his channel, but I'll go ahead and post the link to his channel right here. Very interesting travel vlogs, everyday vlogs, dining, shopping, etc. So make sure to check his channel out. The reason why I carry stuff in a toiletries bag to begin with is because I don't travel that often, unfortunately, but I do go south of the border every weekend to Juarez, Mexico. And, you know, I pack stuff, you know, to take with me for overnight stays over there for the weekend. And that is why I have stuff to carry around with me. So with that being said, let's go ahead and just jump right in. The first thing that I want to mention is the travel bag itself. This is going to be a Dop Kit from Van Heusen. I got this last December during my Christmas or post-Christmas shopping, I think. And I was pretty much interested in getting a Dop Kit like this one. And it's turned out to work really well for me. It actually has like this zippered central compartment right here. Another zippered compartment here on the side, and a handle, you know, for you to carry it around. It actually fits perfectly in my carry-on bag, you know, whenever I stuff my clothes and everything in there, it fits nicely in there. And yeah, it's been giving me really good results. The one that I had previously was this blue one, and this was from obviously a female fragrance set that my mom got years and years ago. And I actually started using this, but I found that it was kind of cumbersome because of the shape. It's actually very kind of tall, and it really was kind of hard to fit into with the rest of my stuff. So that's why I was interested in getting something a little bit more compact but still spacious like this one. So that's the Dop Kit itself, and I'm gonna break up, you know, the products that I'm gonna show you that I usually carry around with me in this bag. I'm gonna try to break them up into separate categories just so, you know, it's easier for me to show and it's easier for me to break down for you. So let's get started. The first products that I'm gonna talk about are my, you know, daily cleansing or face cleansing routine. The first one of them is gonna be the Purity Cleanser by Philosophy. I know that I'm almost running out of this and I probably shouldn't even be talking about it, but I like the bottle because it's very portable. It's a travel size bottle, of course. And this was actually refilled with the last of my full-size cleanser that I used to own, but now I'm down to like this much of it. This is just basically to clean my face, to wash it morning and night, and to get rid of stuff and prepare it for everything else. The second item in the cleansing category is gonna be this toner, Breath of Fresh Air by Lush. This is actually in my March favorites video. If you haven't seen that, you can also check that out. And yeah, I usually don't use toner. I used to skip straight to moisturizer, but I found out that, you know, toning your face is really important. You know, it actually hydrates and, you know, remineralizes your face. And this is something that claims to do that. You just basically spray it on your face, and I've been getting really good results with it. That's why it made my favorites. And yeah, I bring it with me with the rest of my stuff. The next item in these three steps for cleansing is gonna be my moisturizer. I carry a little bit of it inside this eye cream jar that I repurposed. This is the Pond's cream. I've talked about it before. I think I talked about it in one of my favorites video for last year. This is the Pond's cream, the blue one with the blue lid. And I've been really, really loving this moisturizer. It really absorbs really quickly. It doesn't leave a greasy film on your face. It doesn't leave it feeling oily or anything like that. So that's why I carry it around with me. And I don't carry the full jar because it's kind of bulky. So I decided to carry it around in this little jar right here. I also carry with me this little sample of Alginist Complete Eye Renewal Balm. I've talked about this before as well, and it's enough to say that I've been really liking it. I've never understood the importance of an eye balm or an eye cream until I started using this. This actually does help to keep the under eye area nourished and moisturized. So yeah, a little goes a long way, and I've had this for a little while now. So very useful and very effective. Now moving on to the other categories, I guess I can get started with, you know, fragrance and shaving. This is a cologne that I carried with me this weekend. It's the Energy Body Spray by Anthony Body Essentials. I talked about this in a mini haul previously, and I'm really enjoying the scent. It's very fresh. It's described here as cardamom zest. This is not exactly a cologne. It is labeled as a body spray, but it has a very nice lingering fragrance. When you spray it all over yourself, you know, before getting ready, before putting your clothes on, it does last throughout the day, and you can just reapply it whenever you want a burst of scent, if you will. And yeah, this is something that I've been carrying around with me and that I've been loving ever since I purchased it. And of course, you know, my deodorant, this is gonna be from the Nivea men's line, and this is a Mexican deodorant and it's called Cool Kick. I've actually been fond of roll-on deodorants, or this is an antiperspirant, this is not a deodorant, but they've been giving me really good results since I started using them. Stick deodorants leave a film, and spray deodorants are not that effective in controlling wetness and odor, so I've been sticking to roll-on deodorants, and these have been giving me really good results. This is not the deodorant that I use normally. I use another one called Black and White, and it prevents, you know, having stains and stuff on your t-shirts and stuff. So, but they ran out whenever I went to purchase it, so I had to buy this one instead. As far as shaving, I don't usually shave every weekend that I'm there, but when I do, I make sure to carry my Gillette Fusion razor. And I especially like the fact that the blades have like 5 blades on them, so it gives you a really, really close shave. They are expensive though. The cartridges go for like 4 for like $18 or something like that. But you know, you have to keep your face, you have to maintain your skin. So this is somewhat of a good purchase, and it's really good for shaving and giving you the closest, nicest shave possible. And conveniently enough, I have these minis from The Art of Shaving, and these were a gift from my friend Natalie over Christmas. Starting out with the pre-shave oil from The Art of Shaving. And this is really good to prep your skin, to prep your beard and soften it for a close, comfortable shave. Continuing with the shaving cream, this is a sample that I got at Sephora, 100 point perk. And this one is in sandalwood. It actually lathers up really nice. It gets very creamy and stuff. And it works together with the pre-shave oil to give you a nice, closer shave. And the third implement for shaving is the aftershave balm. This one doesn't smell like anything. It actually smells like liquid plastic, in my opinion, but it actually, you know, nourishes your skin, and it prevents, you know, it keeps it from burning whenever you put on your cologne afterwards or something like that. So yeah, this is another thing that I carry around sometimes with me when I shave. Other items that really don't have anything to do with these two categories that I established is this. This is the Garnier Anti-Puff Eye Roller. I'm almost running out of this as well, but this is really good to wake up your eyes, you know, in the morning when you wake up and you feel like your eyes are puffy and, you know, swollen, I guess. This actually does a good job of, like, you know, calming them down and cooling them off, so you can go ahead and get ready and, you know, not look like something that just got out of a coffin. Okay, the next set of products that I carry around with me and that I want to show you guys are all makeup products. Don't judge me, you know, because I've been over this a little bit more, a little bit often before. I don't see makeup as like, ooh, I want to be pretty and I want to look like a girl. This is basically, you know, stuff just to enhance, you know, my facial features, just to keep my skin matte, just to give my skin a unifying tone. And yeah, that's basically why I carry around this stuff with me. So the first thing is gonna be primers. I have 2 primers here. One is gonna be the Porefessional by Benefit. This is a little sample that came to me inside the How to Look Your Best at Everything kit from Sephora. And this has given me really good results. It's actually a pore refining balm. And you know, it minimizes the appearance of pores and it smooths out your skin, you know, and gets you ready for makeup application afterward. I'm gonna close the blinds because it's kind of bothering me. The second primer that I have and that I just bought this weekend was a small version of the Smashbox Photo Finish Foundation Primer. This is the hydrating version. The clear one did not say hydrating on the packaging, but both of them are oil-free. I've been using it, and I'm actually using it right now. I put it on this morning, and it actually gives you a very nice finish to your skin. You know, it hydrates. It doesn't feel that it's like pulled or, you know, dries it out, but it actually does smooth your skin out, and you know, it prepares it, you know, for BB cream or whatever it is that you put on afterward. Moving on to concealers, I actually have 3 concealers. I don't use all 3 at once, but you never know when you have, you know, different needs for stuff and, you know, you want to use something different. The first one is going to be this CoverGirl Fresh Complexion Concealer. This is actually a liquid concealer, and it has a sponge tip applicator like this. This is actually kind of light for me, and I've discovered, you know, since I started using different products, that this one is too light. You actually have to blend the hell out of it just so you can't just so people can't tell that you're actually wearing concealer, but you know, every once in a while I need a little bit of extra coverage, so I carry this around with me. The second concealer that I carry is also from the How to Look Your Best at Everything kit, and it's the Boing Concealer. These are two samples that I got, number one and number two. I actually feel more fond of number two than I do of number one, because this one is the one that matches my skin tone more closely, but I usually use the number one just to brighten up your eyelids, you know, just to, you know, kind of mix them together to obtain a customized shade. And the third one is this one by e.l.f., and this is actually a duo under eye concealer and highlighter. This one is the concealer, of course, and this one's the highlighter. The highlighter does have like this sort of glittery, dewy finish. I've never been fond of it ever since I got it, but the concealer actually kind of works, but it's pretty much the same as this one. So I just throw this around in case I, you know, want to try something different or want to do something different with my face in general. Moving on to BB creams, I usually carry around two. This is the other one. This one is from the Neo Classic Ohm line from the Face Shop. This one is a little bit lighter for me. It's not really my actual tone, because this is probably for more Korean complexions since they're fairer and lighter. But usually, you know, I'll just use this whenever I'm in a hurry or I don't want to put that much stuff on my face. This pretty much just unifies the skin tone and just preps it and leaves it shine free. I also like the fact that it has SPF 40, so this is a good alternative that I also bring around with me. The one that I do stick to using the most is the Magic Skin Beautifier BB Cream from L'Oreal. I actually talked about this in my favorites video from May, I think, from last year, and ever since then I've been using it, and it's been giving me really good results. It does blend really easily into your skin tone. It gives you a nice unified complexion, and it also conceals a little bit, you know, whenever you have dark spots or dark circles around your eyes. It does double up as that, so it's a really good product. And yeah, this is also one that I carry around with me most of the time. I also carry around this CC cream, and this is also from the Face Shop, Be a Brighter Man. I also like it because of the SPF 40 it has. I don't like to use this by itself because it leaves your face like very white looking. Again, probably because of Korean lighter skin tones. But I usually use this because of the SPF, like I said, and because it serves as a base for anything else that you follow up with, you know, with BB cream or anything like that. Sometimes whenever I'm in a rush and I just want to put just, you know, something on my face, I usually put a little bit of this and it gets me good to go. Moving along with the contents, the rest of the contents, I have this little tube of Urban Decay Primer Potion. Of course, it is obvious I don't wear eyeshadow, but this is actually really good to mattify your eyes. I usually have very oily eyelids by the end of the day or afternoon, you know, or something like that, and this actually prevents that. It actually mattifies everything that you put on. My concealer, especially this one, tends to crease a little bit, the Boing concealer, the cream concealer, but this actually prevents that from happening. I'll put on a little dab of it and just spread it around my eyelids, and it takes care of that. It's really good. And yeah, this is also something that I carry on with me. And moving along with face brushes, I have three of them. I have a foundation brush from e.l.f. I have the stippling brush from e.l.f., and this actually does give you a very nice unified smooth application of your makeup, you know, that you can later blend away. And I also have the face brush from e.l.f. I've really not considered buying any other brands of face brushes. If you guys have any recommendations as far as any other effective and affordable face brushes, because they can get really pricey, leave a comment on the comment box below. And yeah, any suggestions are welcome. The other things that I carry on with me are face powder. This is going to be the e.l.f. High Definition Powder. I usually just brush this on, you know, lightly brush it on my face after I'm done with everything. It helps mattify my face and keep it shine free. And yeah, I usually, you know, use it. I don't use the puff that's enclosed with this. I'll use a powder brush and just, you know, spread it all over my face, and that gets rid of that. That gets rid of the shine. I also have this new product that I just bought, and it's the NYX Matte Finish Setting Spray. This is very comparable to the Urban Decay one, which I ran out of last week, but I got this. This is half the price of the Urban Decay one, and it's really good as well. You know, it just sprays it on, you know, leaves your skin, you know, feeling nice and fresh, and it leaves your skin mattified as well. So I'm really liking this. The other product that I have is the e.l.f. Wet Gloss Lash and Brow Mascara. I usually use this on my eyebrows, you know, just to keep them in place, and also in my eyelashes to keep them separated. And finally, I have a face sponge, which you can see is a little bit dirty because it's the one that I'm currently using. And this is useful for like blending stuff and, you know, making sure that everything's spread out evenly all over your face and it doesn't look like you just put on a cake. So those are my contents of my travel toiletries bag. I hope you guys found that interesting in any regard. Please share with me any of your favorite products and leave a comment on the comment box down below. If you have any recommendations, questions, comments, or suggestions about anything that I covered in this video, feel free to drop me a line and like this video, and I will go ahead and talk to you later. Bye.